Welcome to another brand new episode of Quarantine Tech Talk. I'm your host, Divya. I hope you all are safe during this pandemic. Before getting into today's session, I request you all to please subscribe to our channel. Today, we will be discussing about microgrids, and for the discussion, we have Ganesh with us. He is an instrumentation engineer with primary expertise in control system for process automation. His current work areas include intelligent infrastructures, smart energy systems, and renewable energy, specifically focusing on small, micro, and power grid. So let us ask Ganesh, what exactly is a microgrid?
Namaskar, Divya. Thanks for the introduction. Before I try to answer your question as to what a microgrid basically is, I felt that it would help to revisit our understanding of what a power grid is. A power grid basically is a network of interconnected power lines and associated equipment which is used to deliver electricity to a group of loads which we typically call as consumers. The power grid basically is divided into three sections: generation, transmission, and distribution. Generation usually consists of power generation plants which are either fossil fuel based, nuclear, hydro, or even renewable energy based. The energy generated is then transmitted over long distances via the transmission network and received by the substation. These substations are usually closer to the consumers and they deliver the power generated to the consumers via the distribution network. If we see such a topology, it is seen that it is spread over a vast geographical area. The power generation plants need not always be close to the consumers. They are typically located close to where the raw materials required for power generation are available. Now, when we contrast this to a microgrid, the microgrid, as its name itself suggests, is a scaled-down version of the power grid. It is typically a low-voltage system which is restricted to a smaller geographical area. If you want to define what a microgrid is, we can say that it is a group of interconnected loads, distributed energy resources, which are restricted to a smaller geographical area and which may or may not be connected to the centralized power grid. The concept of microgrids basically arose with the need of having self-sustainable societies which have uninterrupted power and which have less dependence on the centralized power grid. How they achieve this is by having local generation sources, backup energy storage systems, such that they need not always depend on the centralized power grid for their requirements.
So Ganesh, tell me one thing, does microgrid mean an energy system with a solar panel?
Not necessarily. It could be with or without solar PV panels. As I mentioned earlier, a microgrid basically is a low voltage system restricted to a smaller geographical area and which may or may not be connected to the centralized power grid. Now, it sustains itself by having several localized generation sources. Typically in microgrids, most of these generation sources are renewable energy based or they are otherwise known as distributed energy resources. Now, there are several other distributed energy resources apart from solar, like wind, micro hydro, biogas, fuel cells, combined heat and power. It is just that solar PV happens to be one of the most widely preferred renewable energy sources. It could be probably attributed to the favorable weather conditions across the world. Otherwise, there are several other options which we could have. And it is also not necessary that it always has to be a renewable energy source. We could even have conventional energy sources like diesel generator sets or UPS-based systems.
So what is on-grid and off-grid?
The terms on-grid and off-grid are usually associated with renewable energy-based systems. It denotes the ability of a renewable energy based system to either operate dependent or independent of the power grid. Now, if we take an example of a solar PV based system, it usually consists of solar PV panels. It might have an external charge controller, or you might have a power conditioning device like an inverter which has an inbuilt charge controller. Now, what differentiates between on-grid and off-grid systems is the availability of a backup energy resource in case of the renewable energy resource being not available. Now, on-grid systems are also referred to as grid interactive systems. So, as the name itself suggests, it refers to those renewable energy based systems which are having an association with the centralized power grid. Now, in an on-grid system, we have an inverter which basically connects to the power grid, and it uses the power grid frequency as a reference. If we take the example of a solar PV based system itself, we have loads connected to the inverter, and suppose the loads are drawing more power than what the solar PV panels are able to produce. In such a case, the excess demand for energy is met by importing power from the power grid. Now, if you take the reverse case, when the loads are drawing much less power than what the solar PV panels are producing, in that case, the excess solar PV energy generated or produced is exported back to the grid. This might seem as a very useful feature, because you can always get more revenue by exporting more power to the power grid. But such systems have a drawback. Since the systems are connected to the power grid, their operation is dependent on the existence of power in the power grid. So the moment there is a power outage, these systems shut down. Now, this feature is called as an anti-islanding feature and is incorporated into the inverter devices for safety precaution reasons. Now, if you take an off-grid system, as the name itself suggests, it has no association with the power grid. It's a standalone power generation system. Now, in such a system, if we assume that the loads are drawing more power than the solar PV energy that is generated, then that excess energy that is demanded by the load has to be offset or met by some backup energy storage device. Now, in case of on-grid systems, it was the power grid. Whereas in case of off-grid systems, you have other storage options like batteries. So in this case, when the load draws more power than what the solar PV panels are able to produce, the excess energy is offset by the batteries. The opposite case is when the loads are drawing less power and the solar PV energy generated is sufficient. In those cases, the solar PV panels provide power to the loads as well as charge the batteries. Now, the drawback of such systems is that since solar PV energy is dependent on the sun, and typically when the sun is not there, and when both the batteries are also drained as well as the solar PV panels are unable to produce sufficient energy, then the loads could be deprived of power. So the two, the main criteria which differentiates probably an on-grid and off-grid system is basically this backup energy option that is available in terms of either the grid or an external energy storage device.
So tell us, how can we set up a simple microgrid?
This is an interesting question. Interesting, I say, because we have a smart grid lab demonstrator here at Amrita, which incorporates the concepts of microgrids in its design and implementation. So I feel we can use some of the experience that we as a team had while designing and setting up the system to answer this question. First and foremost, a microgrid needs to have a group of interconnected loads. So this could basically mean a community consisting of a few households, or it could also mean a combination of households and public spaces such as schools, banks, hospitals, etc. Secondly, the community may or may not be connected to the centralized power grid. In either cases, the microgrid needs to have localized power generation sources. Now, these power generation sources could be renewable energy based or a mixture of renewable energy and conventional energy sources. An important factor to be taken into consideration is that renewable energy is intermittent in nature. So the design needs to incorporate backup energy sources or energy storage devices which complement and supplement the renewable energy generators. Now, the microgrid based on these considerations and factors could basically consist of simply a solar PV based microgrid, or it could also mean a combination of solar PV and wind, or wind and biogas, or it could also be a combination of solar PV and diesel generator sets. Also, as I said earlier, you know, you need to also take into consideration whether we need any backup energy storage devices which need to kick in when the renewable energy sources are insufficient. Lastly and most importantly, a microgrid needs to have a microgrid controller or a microgrid management system. As we have seen so far, a microgrid consists of several entities. It may or may not be connected to the power grid. It has localized power generation sources. There could be a variety of power generation sources. It has backup energy storage devices and different types of loads. So there has to be some system which basically runs the show, and that is done by the microgrid controller. Now, assuming a case wherein we have a microgrid which is connected to the power grid. Now, there could be decisions as to where to source the power from in such a case. You know, this would depend on factors such as the availability of the localized power generation sources. Since I mentioned that renewable energy is intermittent in nature, it could be possible that, you know, the localized power sources are not generating sufficient enough energy. So in such cases, the microgrid controller needs to make the decision as to where to source the power from so as to maintain uninterrupted power supply to the loads. Another case could be when there is a power grid outage. In such a case, the microgrid has to disconnect from the power grid first, and then it needs to function in an islanded mode of operation. Now, while it tries to do so, again, it has to take various factors into consideration. Because a power grid outage could be a short one or it could be for a longer duration. So in that case, it needs to determine what is the current status of the load. That is, how much power is the load consuming? What is the forecast for the load consumption based on the time of day? Depending on that, the microgrid controller has to see what are the various power generation sources available within the microgrid, what is the status of each source, what is the status of each backup energy storage device. You know, based on all these factors, the microgrid controller has to take decisions so as to maintain uninterrupted power supply to the loads. So this basically means a combination of software and efficient hardware to make the whole system work.
Can we call an individual home with a solar panel a microgrid?
As per my knowledge, I do not think we could consider an individual home powered by solar panels as a microgrid. However, in certain circles, the term home microgrid is used by some referring to a consumer who uses one of the two, either an on-grid or an off-grid based system, to achieve some amount of self-sustainability and lower its dependence on the power grid.
Thank you, Ganesh, for this detailed information. Thank you, viewers, for listening to us. If you have any suggestions or doubts regarding this session, please feel free to connect to our team. And before leaving, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Stay tuned for more interesting videos on Quarantine Tech Talk.